Cowboy here, and I want to go on just kind of tell you a little story, sort of a rant about my toaster here. It's a Sunbeam. I've had it for, I don't know, probably 15 to 20 years, somewhere in there. I got it a long time ago. It was a birthday gift, I believe. I used to have another toaster before this one. Gee, imagine that. But I did. It was just a very basic, it was probably a late 80s or early 90s. I think it was a Toastmaster. It doesn't really matter. But it was a very basic, just two-slot metal toaster. Didn't do bagels. It didn't do, you know, it didn't have any fancy buttons or anything. It was just basically you put regular size bread in, you push the button down, and it would make toast. And it actually did it very well. The only problem was I was at this point where I was eating a crap load of bagels, and I like them toasted with lots of butter on them. So I wanted a toaster that I could put a bagel in, and bagels were just too fat to fit into a standard toaster. And I had been kind of talking about that sort of just off the cuff, and I didn't really know if I was going to go out and replace my toaster by saying, gee, it would be nice to have a toaster that did this. And one of my friends actually heard me say that. And as my birthday rolled around, all of a sudden I got this as a present for my birthday. And when I got it, I was like, cool, you know, it's got all kinds of buttons on it. You can like do bagels and you can do pastries. And if you got like frozen waffles, you can do those. And you can tell it, you know, what it is that's in there, so it'll toast it just the right way. And it had this like cool little cancel button that you hit that and it pops up. You don't have to like fight with a lever to pop something up, you know, quick or whatever. And it was, everything actually was pretty cool. When I first got it, it had, you know, the little slide out crumb tray in the bottom instead of having to flip the thing upside down over the sink and pop the trap door open on the bottom and shake the crap out of it. It was like, you know, a really cool modern toaster compared to the kind of very basic one that I had before. And so I took the one that I had, you know, had been using and just kind of put it away and started using this one. And this one actually worked really well for a number of years. But as it aged, it stopped working as well as it did when it was new. And I could say that I identify with that personally, as I don't work as well as I did when I was new either. But what happens is now you can see that the darkness control is set on 7. That's as high as it will go. And so when you put a piece of bread in here to make toast, you press the lever down, the toast goes down in the toaster, the coils all light up and everything. And a few, I don't know, a little while later, the bread pops back up and it's still white. And it might just be turning very slightly blonde around the edges a little bit, but mostly it's still white. It's just kind of white and dried out. And so then what you need to do is you need to push the lever down again and let it run through a whole nother, or actually not a whole nother toasting cycle. You've got to stand there and watch it. And then when it gets to be just the right color looking down the top, you got to hit the cancel button and pop it. Because otherwise, if you just let it go through another full toasting cycle, it'll actually burn the crap out of it. And so that's a pain in the ass. Anytime you want toast, you set the toaster and you can go about your business. And then when it pops, then you've got to go back over and push the lever down again and then stand there and watch it for a minute or a minute and a half or so while it's toasting to make sure that the toast, you know, doesn't burn or, you know, you've got to basically make sure that you've taken it out when the color is right. And so then I thought, I was thinking to myself, gee, I wonder if somewhere on this toaster there's an adjustment that I could make. Because I know old toasters, like the old ones from the 60s and the 70s that were American made, they had the regular, like, it was a lot of times it was a slider, or Sometimes it was a knob, but they had the darkness control on the front that was the one that was easily accessible that you used a lot. But if for say a vintage toaster, if you had to set the darkness all the way up on like burnt toast setting in order to get it to come out, and it was coming out, very pale, like just barely even what you would consider toasted. You could flip the thing upside down, and there would either be a big knob on the bottom that would say, like color timer or something. I've forgotten Smith, not Smith Corona, but actually Smith Corona owned one of the big toaster companies, Proctor Silex, back in the 60s and 70s, and they had a big knob on the bottom, which was like the coarse adjustment. You could make a coarse adjustment to get this knob on the front to where the perfect toast would be like right in the middle of the range, and then you could like move it back and forth a little bit. So you had that adjustment. Other toasters actually might have had like a recessed screw in a hole in the bottom of the toaster that, and sometimes they would actually tell you that, yeah, right here's your adjustment, and turn it, like a quarter of a turn one direction if it's not toasting enough, or a quarter of a turn the other direction, and then see how it toasts. You could go through a lot of bread trying to figure it out, but eventually you could home in on, you could set this where you want it, and then go under, make a little minor tweak, make some toast, see if the color's right. If it's not, you could tweak it a little more, until you get it, the range, to where you want. So I thought, well, maybe they still do that. But then I realized that since this toaster is new enough that it's made in China, the whole thing is electronic. There are no coarse adjustments on it other than the main knob. And so I'm like, well, I really need another toaster then. But then I'm thinking to myself, if I go out and I buy another toaster, my parents went out. They had a kind of a crappy little toaster. They bought a condo down in Florida when they retired, and they had a crappy little toaster that was left because the condo they bought was fully furnished, and there was a toaster there when they moved in, and it was kind of old and crappy. And they were like in the process of redoing the kitchen, and so they went out and they spent big bucks on a really fancy Tefal toaster. And it's really nice. It's got all these bells and whistles on it. It's really cool, and it does all these really cool things except make good toast. It's like, if you get any of that, kind of the wide bread, like the Arnold bread or the Pepperidge Farm bread, that the stuff that's really wide, you have to put the bread in on end because the slots aren't wide enough to fit the bread, in the normal orientation, which means when you try to toast it, the one end of the bread's kind of hangs out the holes at the top because it doesn't lower the bread down in far enough. So you've got to toast it one way, and then you've got to stop, and you're going to take the bread out and flip it over and toast it the other way, which means that you're going to have perfectly toasted ends, and it's going to be all burnt in the middle because that part got toasted twice. And so they still use it, and they still fight with it, but I was like, I don't really need that kind of aggravation. So seeing all these problems that I've had, with this toaster, and knowing that all toasters now are basically of the same ilk, sort of, they're all made in China, they're all electronically controlled, they're all of questionable quality, no matter how much you spend on it. And I don't really need all the features like, the bagel and the pastry and the frozen and all that stuff. I basically, I make toast and I make English muffins. And that's pretty much what I use a toaster for nowadays. And so what I'm really looking for is a toaster that simply makes perfect toast every time. And I think I found it. What I found is actually another Sunbeam. I found this actually on eBay for actually a lot less than they normally go for. The model number, I guess, is that Service 20-3AG, made in the United States of America. Gee, imagine that. By Sunbeam Corporation, Chicago, Illinois. 120 volts, 1375 watts. I tell you, this thing makes serious toast. This other toaster over here, that's only 900 and something watts. And UL approved and all that kind of stuff. What does it look like? Hang on a second and I'll flip it over. There it is. This is what they call a sunbeam. A sunbeam, I don't know if you can see that. A sunbeam radiant control toaster. Notice, you look at it, all the way around, there's no lever. All there is the darkness control on the front. And a couple handles on the ends. This was, at the time, probably the top of the line toaster you could have bought when this was made. Oh, look, you can see myself in it. Hi. But anyways, it's really clean inside. I mean, you can tell it's been used a little bit, but it's really almost new inside. This particular style of toaster, Sunbeam made these starting around 1949, 1950, somewhere around in there. And as far as I know, they made this basically the same toaster with minor changes all the way up until about 1997. And what it does, which is really interesting, most toasters, I'm not sure how the China ones work. The old ones were all mechanical. The very early, when pop-up toasters very first came on the market, a lot of them were operated by a timer that you'd push the lever down and a timer would kick on, and after a certain amount of time went by, the toast would pop up. I'm not sure how your run-of-the-mill mechanical toasters from the 50s, 60s, 70s worked too much. And I really can't tell you how this one works, other than the fact that it doesn't run off a timer, it doesn't run off, waiting for something to heat up to a certain temperature and then releasing and popping the toast up. What it actually does is it reads the heat reflected off of the bread, and it can determine how dark the toast is based on the amount of heat that's reflecting back. And when the toast is the right color, it stops and pops the toast. How does this toaster actually work, you ask, with no levers and no anything to manually put the toast down in? Let me show you. Put one bread in the first slot, and then on the other slot, which says one slice, you put that slice in the second, and the toast automatically lowers. And once it's lowered down in there, the heating elements come on. And they come on very bright. This, like I said, this toaster is using like 1375 watts. It's really, it makes toast in a hurry. You sit back. It should only take a minute or two. Can actually hear it buzzing a little bit. There's so much juice running through that thing. This toaster, I believe, based on the model number and from what I was able to figure it out online, is probably from either the late 80s or sometime in the 90s. It's one of the later models of this toaster, and that's why it's in such good condition. I found it on eBay, I said, and the picture they had of it was really disgustingly dirty. There was like crap all over the chrome. The base had dirt and crap all over it. But the thing is, these toasters normally like the starting price on them a lot of times is like $39, $49, somewhere in that range. And I just saw somebody had one from 1971 that sold. It was brand new in the box, had never been used, sold for over $220, I think. And so when I found this one, including shipping for less than 20 bucks, it just shut off. Okay, we're going to see something. But for less than 20 bucks, including shipping, I jumped on it. Let's see now, once it shuts off, the toast automatically rises back up. And take the toast out. And look at that. Perfectly toasted on both sides. Now I gotta go eat some toast, huh? So that's my solution. Go back to good old quality, American-made ingenuity. I mean, this is what toasters used to be like. You could basically, back in the 60s, you could buy, you know, a $15 toaster, and it would make perfect toast like this without, you know, any sweat. You know, it's just how they were. They basically were designed to do one specific thing, and they all did it very well, and it would tend to last for a long time. These toasters, actually, there are a lot of these toasters around from the 1950s that are still in everyday use. Because they were just built to last. They were built basically to last you a lifetime. This one over here worked really well for maybe 5 years. And then the rest of the time since that, I've been having to mess with it to get any toast out of it. So, you know, what's up with that? That's basically probably by design that it works that way, so that you have to go out and send more money to China to buy another toaster because the one you have doesn't toast right anymore. Why not spend some money and get something that's quality that will last you the rest of your life? What happened to that in this country? Okay, well, that's the end of my little toaster rant and my new Sunbeam toaster, new to me. Semi-vintage, probably from the 1990s. The chrome is almost perfect. There's a few little scratches in the top, but the whole rest of it, all the rest of the way around on the sides and everything, is flawless. There's like not a scratch on it. Like I said, it was real dirty in the eBay pictures. A little Windex, and it came up shining like new. All right, thanks for watching. Please click subscribe, if you would, please, thank you, and please click like. Thanks a lot for watching, and have a great day.